Well, Mr. Mayor, it's a pleasure to be here. Mr. Chairman, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to speak about human security. And as a matter of fact, in my approach to human security, I will try to establish a connection with the economic relativity theory, with the three welfare diamonds theory, as well with the systemic problems that the world economy is currently facing. I will also try to present a path for the future, especially in what concerns what I call a fourth industrial and service revolution. I will also approach the role of the tradable goods sector and the role of the non-tradable goods sector, and finally, the role of the state in the economy. Aha. Well, yes. Mm-hmm. When we talk about human security, we talk about economic security, food security, health security, environmental security, personal security, political security, community security, and traditional security, as you can see in figure one. All these different levels of analysis have an influence in well-being, as well as in the Human Development Index. Economic security has to do with the basic income for individuals and their own families, while food security means the access to basic foods and health security protection from diseases and unhealthy lifestyles. Environmental security relates to protection from pollution and global warming, while personal security means protection from physical violence. Community security means protection from loss of traditional relationships and values, and political security is related to human rights. And the so-called traditional security is linked to state's ability to defend itself against external threats, and therefore we must consider the concepts of soft and hard defense. All these different levels of analysis are connected to the economic relativity theory and to the three welfare diamonds. The economic relativity theory gives a significant importance to the significant importance to the global context, to psychological factors, and to the EFTL approach, follow the leader behavior, putting in question the rationality of the economic agent's behavior. And at the same time, in order to understand the problems concerning human security, we must consider the three welfare diamonds, interconnecting the new macroeconomic diamond that you can see in the left, not very well, but well, you can have an idea. And the new entrepreneurial diamond in the right, and the economic relativity diamond in the center. The new macroeconomic diamond's purpose is a well-succeeded internationalization of the economy. And the factors to be considered should be confidence, research, modernizations, strategic partnership, training, and investment. The lapidator should be the state. The new entrepreneurial diamond's main purpose is a well-succeeded competition. And the factors to be considered should be entrepreneurial organization, product and segmented policies, research and development, adaptation to local conditions, and strategic partnerships. The lapidator should be the enterprise. And the economic relativity's diamond's purpose in the center is well-being. And the factors I have selected are developed standards, good governance, participative structures, social mobility, social structures, and development dynamics. And the lapidator must be the citizen. In short, there is a virtuous triangle interconnecting state, citizen, enterprise, as you can see just below in figure three. This analysis allows us to consider the integrated human development index as, for instance, the dynamic human development index and the sustainable and dynamic human development index. It is also possible to consider the interconnection between the three welfare diamonds and the new conception of cooperation policies and development policies, what we call the Comprehensive Development Framework, CDF. And you can see, in the CDF you have different intervention areas: good governance, strong and independent judicial power, strong financial system, education, health, framework infrastructures, and environmental protection. And in what concerns intervention levels, we have four: debt negotiation, consistent macroeconomic policies, structural adjustment programs, this is country assistance strategies, and institutional reforms. This new conception was responsible for a well-succeeded negotiation between Portugal and Cabo Verde, with the cooperation agreement concerning a peg of the Cabo Verde escudo to the Portuguese escudo. I would like to emphasize also that from the three welfare diamonds, we can easily build and then afterwards understand the UN Development Index. We have the Dynamic Human Development Index with, well, life expectancy at birth, education, gross domestic product per capita, of course, gender-adjusted development index, then percentage of individuals living on an income less than 50% of the average, and long-term unemployment. It has to do with structural unemployment. And then high and medium technology exports as a percentage of total exports and royalties revenue for per thousand of individuals. And then average rate of variation of the capitalistic intensity coefficient and the rate of growth of the GDP, gross domestic product, in the last 5 years. And then we also have the degree of political participation. And we also can understand the Sustainable and Dynamic Human Development Index, where we also consider the carbon dioxide emissions. I would like now to emphasize also that we are facing some systemic problems in the world economy. And this is important for human security. As a matter of fact, there has been lately a change during the last decade in the labor market sensibility to Okun's law. There was an increase in the unemployment natural rate in developed economies. And this evolution cannot be inverted if we are only considering the tradable goods sector. At the same time, there is a new Malthusian syndrome. During the last years, and regarding the pattern of consumption, we may say that there has been a high increase in the intermediate countries. But the developed countries are facing production stagnation. And therefore, it will be very difficult for the intermediate countries to avoid the deceleration of growth. That tendency to a growth deceleration would imply a deceleration in the process of transfer of labor from the traditional sector to the modern sector, accordingly to Rani's and Fay model, thus questioning the present expectations concerning the future evolution of the standards of living in those countries. So this means that we can have potential social problems with intermediate and peripheral countries. And we also have a third problem, which concerns the role of the state in the future. In that respect, I would like to emphasize that there is what we call a Laffer curve as regards the state dimension and well-being. As you can see in figure 8. And you can see that the Laffer curve for developed countries is different, just in the right side, from the Laffer curve relating state dimension with the well-being in intermediate countries and less developed countries. As Laffer curve should be different when considered, well, for instance, a developed country and an intermediate country, we can conclude that each economy represents a special case to be considered, taking into consideration the specific level of development, its culture, and its social structures. Do we have any ideas about the solutions to the systemic problems we are presently facing? I believe we may have some. First, I believe in a fourth industrial and social revolution based in two strategic sectors, health and energy. I believe that the technological progress in the health sector will allow for an increase as regards the life expectancy and for a positive evolution of medical prices and medical devices, thus creating new opportunities. I believe that technological progress of the energetic sector will allow for a substantial decrease as regards marginal production costs. We already have the good example of what is happening with the shale gas in the United States of America. I believe in a new conception of the role of the states, based in the principles of flexibility, mobility, and efficiency, considering at the same time the positive contributions of Keynesian approach, of the Keynesian approach in what concerns monetary and financial policies. I believe in a strengthening of the intervention of international institutions concerning supervision and foreign aid. And I also believe that although it is really important to give priority to the tradable goods sector, it is necessary to consider investment programs in the domestic sector, non-tradable goods sector, so that we can attain a significant decrease in the unemployment rate. This means that from a growth velocity point of view, precisely, a dual economy presents some advantages. And finally, a world about traditional security. There is a certain tendency to support the idea of putting in practice a soft defense strategy because economies are facing budgetary constraints. This tendency is perfectly understandable. But in my opinion, it is only possible to avoid a generalized international conflict if the main Western democracies also understand that it is necessary to implement a hard defense strategy. It will be imperative to attain an adequate balance between soft defense and hard defense. In conclusion, the world is facing very complex problems. But as a very well-known Portuguese poet, Fernando Pessoa, has said, to be happy is to acknowledge that life is worth living despite all the challenges, misunderstandings, and periods of crisis. To be happy means to stop being the victim of problems and to become the author of our own history. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Our last speaker will be Mariana van Zeller.